The next symmetry operator after the rotation axis, which we represented by the capital X, right? We called it capital X, will be what is referred to as the mirror plane, right? It is a very simple symmetry operator. So this is the mirror plane. This molecule possesses the mirror plane. Okay, the molecule comprises of all these 8 atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. This entire molecule actually possesses the mirror symmetry. So if you take a look at H2O, water molecule, it possesses a mirror symmetry, and in addition to that it possesses something. What else does it possess? This is water molecule, this is oxygen. It has a mirror here, right? There is definitely a mirror here. There is a mirror perpendicular to this tablet, right, like this, which I represented this way. And then there is also a two-fold symmetry, right? If I rotate it by two-fold about the same axis, this will come here and this will go there, and you will not be able to distinguish. Sorry, I'm making a mistake here. Oxygen, hydrogen, hydrogen. You can't distinguish between the two hydrogens. Consequently, you have a two-fold symmetry as well. And you also may have another symmetry which is along the plane of this thing, so something like that, a mirror which is cutting these spheres that way, right? There is also a symmetry element that is going to be present. Is that clear? But the presence of this mirror and the one that is perpendicular to it automatically implies that there is a two-fold symmetry, right? If there are two mirrors that are perpendicular to each other, it will automatically imply that there is a two-fold symmetry passing through the line of intersection between these two mirrors. There is a mirror like that, and there is a mirror like that. There is automatically, if there are two, one, the presence of any two automatically implies the presence of the third one. So this is something that we have to keep in mind. So whenever we represent these, the symmetry of these elements, it may not be necessary to talk about all the symmetry elements that particular molecule has, because you know you will have cases where the presence of any two automatically implies the presence of the other. Okay, this is something to keep in mind. The next operation is called as the inversion. This entire molecule, the entire thing comprising of the 8 atoms, possesses the inversion. So there is a point through which you can invert the coordinates of these atoms. For example, this will come to the other end, this gray will go to this one, is going to this, this one is coming to this one. So a three-dimensional okay. So you see that this gray atom is going through these black ones. This is the inversion center. This is the center through which I am inverting it. It is going to the other end. This green one is coming here and this red one is going right there. Okay. These are called as the inversion. This is called as the inversion center, and the symmetry element is represented by using one bar. That is the symbol for the inversion center. The symbol for, what is the symbol for your mirror?
M.
Just M. And what is the symbol for the axis of rotation? Rotation symmetry operator? X. The X fold or N fold is 2 or 3 or 4 or 6 is basically the symbol. Okay. These symbols are called as, anybody know the name of these symbols? It is not the Schoenflies symbol. They are called as the Hermann-Maugin symbols. Okay, we will introduce those symbols in a little bit. That's a much more useful way of talking about symmetry operators. So we talked about separate symmetry operations such as the rotation and mirror and inversion. Okay. Now we will talk about compound symmetry operations and combination symmetry operations, which involves both of them, which involves maybe two operations like rotation and inversion or rotation and a mirror. So this is an operation which involves a four-fold rotation and an inversion, but each of the symmetry elements are completely lost. Let us take a look at this molecule. So 1, 3, 4 and 2 are the atoms that are making up the molecule, right? You are able to see 2 right here, 2. So this is 2, okay, 2, 4. This is 4, atom number 4, this is atom number 3 and this is atom number 1. Okay. Now this entire set of 4 atoms has the symmetry 4 bar. That means I perform a 4-fold rotation and an inversion, okay, I will be able to make this entire molecule coincide with itself. Take a 4-fold rotation and invert all the atoms, you will be able to generate exactly this structure. So how do you generate these structures? You do these operations over and over again until they start repeating. For example, 4-fold rotation, inversion, I did it once. So I started off with, look at the way I write it, it is kind of going to be a little bit tricky. So I started off with an atom which is above the plane. So I put a circle and I put a plus sign. Okay. I performed a 4-fold rotation. I perform a 4-fold rotation, but there is no atom that's going to come over there. I perform an inversion, so there's going to be an atom, but that is below the plane. That's below the plane. Now I keep doing this again. So I perform a 4-fold rotation on the lower plane and invert it, so I get a plus or minus?
Plus.
Very good. So I perform a 4-fold rotation, perform an inversion, I get a minus. So the top view of this entire thing is going to look like this. There is going to be plus, plus, minus, minus. However, neither the 4-fold rotation nor the inversion are separately present in this molecule. What is present is the 4-fold rotation plus an inversion, right? The next one is 4 over m. I am giving you an example. 4-fold rotation with a mirror plane that is perpendicular to the axis of the 4-fold rotation. So it should not be too hard for you to look at this molecule. So again, how do we generate such structures for our understanding? We take one atom and keep applying the operations over and over again until we generate enough number of atoms so that they start repeating themselves. So let us start from 1. So we start from 1. This is 1, the top view is 1. Perform a 4-fold rotation and a mirror perpendicular to it. Consequently, I will generate an atom here, right? Again, a 4-fold rotation and a 4-fold rotation of the bottom one and a mirror plane. So I will generate one on top. A 4-fold rotation and a mirror, I will generate a minus. A 4-fold, this is what? This is what? This is plus, right? A 4-fold rotation and a mirror. So right beneath this, there is also going to be a atom with minus, right? A 4-fold rotation and a mirror plane. So that will be a plus, and keep doing it, you will get a minus here, sorry, minus, a plus, and there was also a minus, and here you will have a plus. So this molecule, a 4-fold rotation and a mirror perpendicular to it, has both 4-fold rotation and a mirror, right? Both the operations are actually present when I perform this 4 over n. Are you able to see that? There is both a 4-fold rotation and a mirror. So this, so okay, take take the is there a four-fold rotation? You're able to see if I take the entire thing. So this is the so if I take this and rotate it by 90 degrees, the entire molecule. Now the entire molecule involves all the 8 atoms. Okay, if I rotate it by 90 degrees, all the atoms are going to the one is going to coincide with 4, 4 with 3, 3 with 2, 2 with 1, and 5 with 8, 8 with 7, 7 with 6, 6 with 5. And I won't be able to tell the difference whether the operation 4-fold was performed or not. If I put a mirror perpendicular to the 4-fold rotation, 3 will go to 8, 2 will reflect with 7, and whatever is here, 1, 2, 3, 4 will go to 5, 1 will go to 6. Okay. So, 4-fold rotation and a mirror plane perpendicular to it has both 4 and the mirror, both of them are there, unlike the case of 4 bar where neither the 4 nor the inversion were actually present in the molecule. Separately they were not present. Is that okay? So this is the 4 bar one. So if you look at it this way, both the plus and the minus atoms essentially coincide. Right, the plane below that you see 5, below 3 you see 8, below 7 you see 2, below 1 you see 6. So this is another operation called as 2 bar. 2 bar means what? 4 bar means 4 fold rotation and an inversion. 2 bar means 2 fold rotation and inversion. But you see that a 2 fold rotation and an inversion, neither the 2 fold is present. The 2 fold is not present separately for this molecule. It involves molecule 1 and atom 1 and atom 2. For this molecule, you do not have separately the 2 fold rotation. Separately, you do not have the inversion also. But the 2 fold rotation plus an inversion is resulting in M. So, 2 fold rotation plus an inversion is the same as a mirror plane. So, these sort of things will come a couple of times. The presence of 2 of these things will mean something else. Consequently, like I mentioned previously, we do not have to specify all of them if you knew that the presence of 2 means the other.